So we've learned about how to represent directions, okay? By the way, why did we learn how to represent directions? Because for many crystals, their properties or behavior is dependent on the direction in which the external stimuli is applied, okay? So if you take an example of a piezoelectric crystal, if you are going to apply stress in a certain direction, then you will see that a potential difference develops across another set of directions. Okay, so we must be knowing what these directions are to understand and study their behaviors or properties. Okay, so we've learned about representing directions. Now we are going to see how to represent a plane. Okay, what is a crystallographic plane? It is a plane that passes through a lattice point. Okay, so just like you have directions being represented by three numbers A, B, C, you do not have commas in between. We have three set of numbers which represent a plane, which are H, K and L and written in a bracket. Okay, your circular brackets. Your direction was written in square brackets. Family of directions is written in angular brackets. Your planes are written in circular brackets, and family of planes are written in these curly brackets. Okay, so let's understand what are these Miller indices H, K, L, which represent a particular crystallographic plane. Okay, so your Miller indices are the integers H, K, L which have the same ratios with one another as the reciprocal of intercepts of the plane on the axes. Okay, let's try to understand the meaning of this definition. Let's just say that I have a plane which is like this. Okay, let's just say I have a plane which is like this, and I want to find out Miller indices for this plane. Okay, a Miller indice for this particular plane is going to define what this plane is going to represent this plane. Okay, so let's just say that this is half, this is also half, and this is also half. Okay, so over here what you have is the intercept of this particular plane. Let me just shade it. The intercept of this particular plane on x-axis is half, right? On y-axis is half, on z-axis is half. Now Miller indices are integers which have same ratio with one another as the reciprocal of intercepts. Okay, my intercepts are half, half, half. We are looking at integers which are having the same ratios as the reciprocal of these intercepts. So the reciprocal would be 2, 2, 2, and hence the Miller indices of this particular plane is 2, 2, 2. Okay, just understand, you're not necessarily looking for smallest set of integers as you were when you were representing your directions. Okay, so the Miller indices that represent the plane which is shaded over here is 2, 2, 2. Let's take another example. Now let's just say that you want to find out the Miller indices for this particular plane. Okay, we are talking about this plane. So I'll just shade it up for you. We are looking at this plane. So what we have to do to get the Miller indices is first get the intercepts. Okay, so on the x-axis this plane does not have a intercept. Okay, so intercept is at infinity. Okay, so your x-axis, I am going to say the intercept length is infinity. Okay, at y-axis the length of the intercept is 1. Okay, we are looking at a cubic cell and its length is 1.